Okay. Well, that sucked. So, had one open the belly pan. Thank God for rice grips. Let's see if we can see here. Maybe this will be better. That sucks. There you go. See this rod here? Fits through the spring and I lifted it before it fell out, so I had to get the pan. Put the spring back through the rod through the spring, which then pulls up and drive. Feed her through. Grab a new nut. Thread that on. That's not bad. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna double nut it. I'm gonna leave them loose for now because I'm gonna fire it up. I'm gonna gas it up first, check the oil. Gas it up. And once I know this thing gotta take off by itself, because you over tighten this now. You saw it up, let's take it off. Alright, let's put the belly pan back on. Definitely a cool tool. Rice grips and the Zawzaw and the BFH. And that's the score of good day's work, those tools. Sorry about hacking it up with vice grips, but that's all I got. Alright, let's turn you around and see what you see over here. Get a little container there. My back isn't the best anymore, so I have to put a little bit of time in the can. Got me one of these safety cans. And generally what I do is before I fill up the container, always, always, always stable my gas. I don't care if it's summer or winter, then I don't have to remember how long it's sitting, blah, blah. It cleans the carburetor. I've never, ever had an issue with a carburetor after, since I've been using this. So just my recommendation. All right. Let's put the built-in funnel back on. Put in some gas, stabilize gas, put a little container. Just to let you know, this was $3.35 a gallon. $3.35 a gallon. Unbelievable. Muppet Enfield, it's $3.35. Down in Manchester was $3.26. Down in Sellington, same price, $3.26. I don't know if you guys got my link I sent the other day, but gas is going up to what they say in the news, $3.50 to $3.75 by spring. So, isn't that a bunch of shit? Alright, let's see where we are. Alright. Gas in here. Tell you the truth, this 9-horse Briggs snow motor on this Simplicity, 9-horse overhead valve, it does not use much gas. It's actually pretty fuel efficient, which I'm surprised.
I ran this unit 3 hours the other day. 3 hours. On Blaststorm. When we had 27 inches. I mean, it worked its nut off. And I didn't even use a whole tank. Believe me. Seriously. Quite impressed. I use this little container because it's easier to control the flow of fuel. You know, spill it and I don't have to hold a, you know, with 7 gallons, 7 pounds per gallon of fuel. I don't want to hold 35 pounds above my waist and waste my lower back. Just doing this hurts my lower back. Believe it or not. Put that over here. Get my rag. Check the fuel. Let's see what we got. The oil, excuse me, oil. It's only had mobile once, it was new. Beautiful, beautiful. I already know we got a cooler here. Tell you the truth, I like just to electric started, but we don't got, so turn the choke on, turn the throttle up, a little prime, fuel is on already, let's see what it does. Come on, baby. It's definitely cold. Anybody knows me, like Sugar Kid 94, I don't like to hack anything. Alright, I'm gonna put you down and pick you back up. I gotta get some needle nose pliers out of the trunk. Be right back, guys. Stand by.